A few months ago, we posted this really cool video that shows what your brain looks like during a concussion. And I gotta say, it makes me a little bit queasy if I watch it for too long. And judging from the comments, it seems like some of you felt the same way. But some of you were a little skeptical. Like, is the brain really that wobbly? Or what about the brain fluid? Doesn't that cushion the blow? And honestly, we were wondering about these things too. So we called up UC Berkeley neurologist Bob Knight to get to the bottom of it. And he told us what exactly happens to the brain during a concussion. And most surprisingly, there's one type of blow that is really dangerous for your brain. Okay, so first things first, is the brain really that jiggly?
If you took a brain fresh out of the skull, you'd be a little bit shocked. It almost feels like you're holding a jello mold. Your brain is not designed to be hit. It's as simple as that.
Okay, but what about the brain fluid? Doesn't that cushion things?
You saw in that demonstration how the forces affect the brain. Now, the brain doesn't actually move that much because it's surrounded pretty tight by spinal fluid, but the forces certainly move in those various directions from trauma.
In fact, that fluid serves another purpose, and that's to transport vital nutrients throughout the brain and spinal cord. So while there's a thin layer of cerebrospinal fluid around the brain that keeps it from moving, it's not enough to stop the brain from hitting the skull during a traumatic hit to the head.
So let's say you fall and land just on the back of your skull, and it'll hit there, maybe you'll see stars, but you're not going to damage anything. The brain will now bounce back and hit these incredibly sharp ridges where your temporal lobe sits and your frontal lobe sits.
So we normally think of the skull as protecting the brain, but those ridges in the skull can actually cause brain damage. We noticed that some of you have actually had a concussion before. Okay, actually, it seems like a lot of you have. A concussion is temporary. You know the symptoms. Headache, memory loss, sleep issues, and you might even black out after a hit. But when they happen over and over, concussions can cause damage to the frontal lobe, which is the part of the brain that helps us make decisions and control our impulses. Now, the study of this brain region traces back to a story that's in every neuroscience textbook. This is Phineas Gage, and this is the large iron rod that went through his skull. Now, this happened while he was laying track for a railroad company. Neuroscientists are obsessed with this story because of what they learned about the brain.
They had it 150th anniversary of his injury, and they were actually selling these little things. And this is actually an exact copy of the rod that went through his head. Who would basically, they would blow up rocks, they'd use with this end of the rod to chip, they'd drill a big hole, put powder in, tamp it down, and it sparked, the rod went flying, went under his chin, came out the top of his head. He lived amazingly.
The injury dramatically changed his personality. People described Phineas as suddenly becoming vulgar and profane. Scientists realized it was due to the frontal lobe damage. So while a concussion might not seem as bad as a giant spike going through your skull, a lot of concussions can add up.
And you'll see some of these athletes that have made it into the press, they end up doing really bad things.
Charging the defendant, Aaron Hernandez, with murder. What say you, Madam Foreperson?
Guilty of murder in the first degree.
And people say, gee, what's wrong with them? Well, in fact, when you look at their autopsies, they have chronic traumatic encephalopathy.
Here's a cross-section of a typical brain. And here's the brain of a former football player with advanced CTE. Repeated head injuries will lead to personality changes, then memory problems, and eventually it can cause dementia. The dark areas here are buildup of a protein called tau. This substance can disrupt how our neurons function, and you would see a similar tau buildup in the brains of Alzheimer's patients. But it's not just repetitive injuries. There's one type of hit that's really dangerous, and it's caused by rotational forces, like when you get hit from the side.
I think the simplest example of, you know, rotational force, if you take a boxing match and you see some person, they've been hit 50 times in the face with a jab. Then their opposing fighter sneaks in and hits them in the jaw, their head spins, and they collapse. And that's because you put a torque to the brain, and the brain just can't stand torque.
Rotation can cause fibers in your brain, known as axons, to stretch or even tear.
So the axons basically are the equivalent of wires connecting one cell's juice to another cell's juice.
Like the power lines of the brain. That knockout punch is actually stretching those axons to the point of no return. Once they snap from a strong rotational force, they really can't grow back, and the damage is permanent. Okay, so you might be wondering, what about helmets? How much do those actually protect the brain? Well, you might be surprised. Helmet technology really hasn't changed in the last few decades. But there's one small design change that could make your helmet way better at protecting your brain. Our next episode will break it all down, so be sure to subscribe to Figure One so you don't miss it.